Caesar, a biased source of course, described Vercingetorix as a man of boundless energy and stoic discipline, yet this was mixed with a brutal streak. Vercingetorix was from an interesting family. His powerful father, Celtilus, had been killed by his fellow Gauls after trying to declare himself king of all of Gaul. Vercingetorix soon raised an army, however, using strict discipline to maintain order. According to Caesar, Vercingetorix punished disloyalty by torture and death, and was even said to cut his troops' ears off or gouge out one of their eyes to maintain discipline. In his campaign against the occupying Roman force, Vercingetorix employed scorch earth tactics. In a council of war in 52 BC, Vercingetorix told his fellow Celts that we must strive by every means to prevent the Romans from obtaining forage and supplies. Along the enemy's line of march, we must burn all the villages and farms within the radius that the foragers could cover. His soldiers duly obliged, burning as many as 20 towns in one day along the Roman line. This strategy worked relatively well for a period, as the Gauls managed to make Caesar's campaign arduous for a time. Vercingetorix was further emboldened after his forces successfully managed to defend Gergovia, an important fortified town of the Arverni tribe, against a Roman siege. Caesar himself estimated that 700 Roman soldiers, including 46 centurions, were killed at the Battle of Gergovia, but the actual figure is likely to be in the thousands. Caesar was eventually forced to retreat, and he was pursued by Vercingetorix's forces. This pursuit did not last long, however, with Vercingetorix soon forced to retreat to the town of Alesia. The Gallic force was estimated to number around 80,000 soldiers. Caesar soon arrived in Alesia and decided that the best tactic was to encircle the town with a series of fortifications, aiming to deprive the Gauls of supplies. This is one interesting aspect of Roman soldiers. They appeared to be half soldiers, half construction workers, as they routinely managed to complete large construction projects with seemingly little effort. It is estimated that the Romans built 16.7 kilometers of fortifications around Alesia. Caesar's strategy to starve the Gauls out from Alesia was correct, as Vercingetorix only had around 30 days of rations for his men. The Celtic leader soon sent word for a Gallic relief army to be sent from surrounding areas. When Caesar learned of the plan for a Gallic relief army, the Roman general instructed his forces to build a second circle of defences, this time to protect the Romans from the relief army. His troops duly obliged, building yet more fortifications around their position. Shortly after, the massive Gallic relief army arrived, totaling 250,000 men. In the following days, the Gauls attacked the Romans from both directions, and just about found a weak spot in the Roman fortifications. There was a gap in the outer Roman fortifications due to a steep hill, and the Gauls took advantage, concentrating massive numbers at this point. Despite some initial Gallic success, Caesar acted swiftly when realizing the strategic vulnerability and managed to patch this up. After stabilizing, the Romans routed the Gauls, leading many to flee. This was a devastating defeat for Gallic independence. The following day, the Gallic leaders inside Alesia met to discuss their position. According to Caesar, Vercingetorix addressed the meeting. He said that he had not undertaken the war for private ends, but for national liberty, and since I now accept my fate, I place myself at your disposal. Make amends to the Romans by killing me, or surrender me alive as you think best. They decided to hand Vercingetorix over to Caesar and to surrender. Vercingetorix was placed in Roman chains and imprisoned. Years later, between 49 and 46 BC, Vercingetorix was paraded through the streets of Rome during one of Caesar's triumphs, and was then beheaded. Despite his death and defeat, Vercingetorix remains a symbol of national liberty throughout France and the world.